Gears play a very important role in HX50. They take the 400 horsepower that the GT50 provides and deliver it straight to the rotors. Now, that means the gears in HX50 go through a lot of stresses. So how do we go from a very high-grade material to something that can actually withstand the forces it sees throughout its life? Now, before we talk to Jace about the gears, I just want to point out the obvious in that the CMM machine room is being constructed. Now, in a later video, we'll go over what the CMM machine does, but for now, that's all. So if we let Jace talk about the gears and how we deliver gears for HX50.
So gears are pretty central to helicopters. Helicopters are far more machine than they are aircraft, but gears themselves are relatively complicated things to make well. We need to start with a high performance alloy steel, but we need to ensure that the flanks of the teeth themselves, the bits that actually roll against each other, are very, very hard to withstand the intense wear that they see in service. And it's that requirement for a dual nature property from the material that sets out a lot of the processes that you have to go through to make gears. So essentially what we have to do is buy high grade alloy steel, and then we can machine that alloy steel through various processes to create the shanks of the gears, and then we take the top off that to create a blank for the gears, and then eventually rough out the teeth in the gear. But at that point, we then get into a whole different range of processes where we have to measure what we've done to make sure the gear is suitably precise to be able to work properly. But we also then have to go and prepare the gear to be case hardened. So we have to use various plating processes to mask off the areas that we don't want to harden, and then subject this to a carburizing process where we allow additional carbon to go in to a certain controlled depth on the teeth of the gear to harden them and give them the hardness that they need for long life and wear resistance. When that gear comes back out of the furnace, it tends to have this kind of scale that you can see in here on it, which is just the residue that we can clean off. And then the next stage that we have to go through is to fine machine the teeth to get very, very, very close tolerances on the mating teeth to make sure that the transmission error is minimized. If these teeth weren't equally spaced, if the dimensions of the teeth weren't controlled properly, then even if we put a uniform motion into the input shaft, you'd get a jerky motion out of the output shaft, and that would create noise and vibration and limit the life and performance of the teeth. So for that macro reason, you need to make sure that the teeth are very accurate. But much more than that, the loads that are passed from tooth to tooth rely on the teeth being able to create a large contact patch that you control very carefully to keep the stresses not only in the surface but in the subsurface area of the tooth to a tolerable level for the material. And so for all of those reasons, it's absolutely vital that we can control the tolerances of the manufacturing process to an extremely high level. And much more than that, it's not good enough just to be able to make gears to the right tolerances and hit the accuracy and precision that you need. We also need to know that at all stages of that manufacturing process, the roughing stages, the heat treatment, the plating, all of those things, even finish machining the hardened tooth, we need to make sure that the heat generated by finish machining doesn't degrade the hardened material properties that we created by carburizing. So each of those requirements creates inspection requirements for us. We need to make sure that the hard shell of the tooth persists until the end of the manufacturing process, and that you've got exactly the case depth that you need. You haven't burnt or heated any of it during machining. We have to make sure the roots of these teeth, the gap in between the two teeth at the bottom there is free from any machining marks or damage. There's no cracks been exposed or flaws been exposed or no defects in any of these areas because the stresses that these gears are subjected to are enormous. And so the gear manufacturing process is not just about being able to make the teeth, it's about being able to make a complex geometry that's defect-free and has the correct metallurgy to be able to deliver the performance that you need in service. So it's a very complicated process, but it's critical to making helicopters. And then beyond that, the way that we qualify these things is to test them. And ultimately, the only way that you can qualify a helicopter transmission drivetrain with complete confidence is to run it throughout the duty cycle and life that you anticipate in service. But those are big, long-term, expensive tests. And so what you do in the short term to ensure that you're going to pass that test is do much more controlled fatigue testing on representative gear specimens. And this is a Spur gear specimen that we've manufactured using our in-house gear manufacturing process. It has all of the features that many of the gears in the helicopter transmission does. And then this gear will actually go on a test rig and be subjected to different load levels, different stress levels, and different numbers of cycles to build up an SN curve that will allow us to accurately predict how many cycles we can expect these gears to last for in service. And that's not to clear it for flight. What that does is it gives us the confidence that we're going to pass our long-term fatigue testing of the full aircraft transmission. Because the one thing that you can't afford to do when you're on a compressed time scale is get to 4,999.9 hours and then have a fatigue failure. So we need to know we're going to pass those tests with a high degree of confidence. So we use fatigue testing on specimen gears like this to de-risk that whole process.
So there we have it. Gears for HX50 are a little more complicated than they may seem. So if you enjoyed this video, be sure to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions, be sure to put them down in the comments.